Shubhodaya. We have been covering the pillars of yoga, Ashtanga Yoga. Ashtanga Yoga, it's a 8-level storied building. The basement, foundation of this castle should be very strong so that our practice gets sustained. It won't collapse halfway through. The foundation of yoga are Yama and Niyama. Yama and Niyama are the rules and regulations which we need to follow so that our sadhana gets, we are successful in our sadhana. Yama and Niyama. Yama, it's a purpose of Yama. It's prompting us. Our life should be of use for others. If our life is not of use for others, our life is a futile life. It's a useless life. We should lead a life such a way that our existence be of use for others. Niyama talks about in order for us, our life to be of value for others, we should have capacity within. We should have something within which is of value for others. To add value for others, I should enrich myself. To enrich myself, that is Niyama is talking about. Niyama 5 in number, I have been covering the Niyamas, Shaucha, Santosha, Tapa, Swadhyaya, Ishwara Pranidhana. Today I will go to the Swadhyaya, will touch upon and go to the Ishwara Pranidhana. And five Yamas we touched upon: Ahimsa, Satya, Asteya, Brahmacharya, Aparigraha. And the Patanjali talks about Ete, Jati, Desha, Kala, Samaya. It's this one, Samaya Vachinna, Sarvabhaumam, Mahavratam. Everyone, it's irrespective of the religion, irrespective of the denomination we are coming from, irrespective of the country we are from, where we are living, irrespective of the time, what time we are living. It's between 1950 to 2020, 2050, whatever time, or in the past 500 years back, or in the next 500 years, after 500 years. This law is universal. This everyone must follow to have a harmony in the society and harmony within. And a harmonious existence everyone must follow. And I have been covering the Swadhyaya. Swadhyaya, it's Shaucha. Purity in living leads to happiness, Santosha. Santosha enhances. Santosha with happiness, when the Santosha happiness goes, I want more of this happiness. To get that one, I start investing time for myself. I start going within. That is called as tapas. To go within, I need a guide. How to go within? How to, that guide is called as Swadhyaya. Swadhyaya, I touched upon the couple of meanings. Swadhyaya, swa means self-study. You have to study, self-study. In the classroom, I can go and in the 200 people are there, I am one among the 200 students. And after the teacher delivers the lecture, now I have to retreat myself and I have to reflect on that one. It is a onus back onto me, swa adhyaya. And what I am studying, swa adhyaya. Swa means swatantra, one who is complete, one who is perfect. I am reading about that one. And that is another dimension. I am reading about something, reflecting upon something is perfect, something is absolute. I want to know about that one. And I come across people when I go for a walk and all, some people, most of them, very dull. There is no luster in the face, no joy in the life. And I was, if I ask somebody, they say, have a business problem, I have financial problem, I lost job, I have family issue, I have health issue, so many problems. They are only, their attention thinking about what I don't have. I was thinking, human life is not meant to be like this. Human life should be bubbling with joy. Yesterday in Bhagavatam class, we touched upon that the species, various classification of species. We are at the pinnacle of the species, and having reached the pinnacle, still it's sulking, no joy in the life. And also I have come across people always in joy, always happy. They also having the similar situation outside, but how can this person be always happy? And whereas the most of us are always a dull face, a gloomy face, and always whinging and cringing, not satisfied. And that is the depends upon the mind. Mind is the source of happiness or the sorrow. In Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna talks about Matra Sparshastu Kaunteya Shitoshna Sukadukkadaham Agama Payino Anitya Stam Stitikshvastva Bharatam. This mind get attached. Where it is getting attached? It is getting attached to the trivial things, the things which are subject to change. It is getting attached only to that one, leading, it is pulling my energy down, making me feel dull in my life. And it's a matra, my attachment, how I attach my mind. Swadhyaya plays a very dominant role. In the Swadhyaya, in the scriptures, it is talking about the great achievers, great inspirers in their life. If you read about that one, your life also get uplifted. When I was in the 5th standard, I was in a history book. I was reading about King Krishnadevaraya. His small statue was also there in the textbook. And I asked my father, it's almost 500 years since he has gone, and why I am still reading about him? And what is the purpose? After 500 years, I am reading about him. My father said, he was a great king. He dedicated his life for his subjects. He did so much for his people. That is why you are still reading about him. And he said, if you also lead a life that way, dedicating your life for others, people will read about you after you go also. When I was still around 11 years or 12 years, that triggered my mind. It was every day, it was an insight. I should do something for others, not for myself. The scripture I read, that something about some great person, that inspired my life also. The Swadhyaya, when I read a text that I should not see, that when I read a Mahabharata or some the religion where I come from, and every religious text talks about great people, when I read, so what? And it is not so what, it is mentioning about great people, their purpose of mentioning great people. You also become something special. But otherwise, there is no point in telling somebody was great 500 years back, 1000 years back, 2000 years back. So what? It is mentioning so that you also become great in your life. So that others, you are an inspiration for generations to come. The Swadhyaya, it is talking about something to inspire your life. You should get illumined. And Swadhyaya in the text, religion, whatever religion I am coming from, religion, all religions are like a highway. Highway, and in the highway, everyone is going. And when more and more people are traveling, slowly we only look at the only ritual part of the religion, and slowly the content is forgotten, only the ritual part. And what the religion is saying at certain point, that religion, the religious texts, the scriptures, it is talking about the religion has become very only ritualistic. No content is lost, that it is saying that after traveling, take a momentum while traveling in the highway and get a stamina and take an exit at certain point and start reflecting what it means. It requires immense courage for me to take an exit from the highway. That is called a spirituality. I should start reflecting what it means, and those who have taken the exit and start reflecting within, that after realizing that one, they will come back and join the highway again to motivate, to inspire the people traveling. It's not the only ritualistic part, there is a content part also. To motivate them, those who have taken the exit, and after realizing, they will jump back into the highway and motivate. Why they do that one? They motivate, inspire others. That you, they're doing the study of the scriptures, and they motivate the co-travelers to lead a glorious life. And the religious texts, it is talking about your life is not focused on trivial things. You should think of something glorious, something perfect. And when you start thinking on the perfect, glorious, and slowly my energy level, ojas, tejas, inner energy starts awakening. And when I'm thinking about the good, positive, my positivity in my life increases. Positive outlook. I will have positive outlook in my life. I may have problems in my life, pinpricks in the life, but this reading about that one, one goes above the threshold of all the problems, and positivity in the life increases, leads a positive life. And why I am reading, contemplating on the positive most, the most positive person. And when I am reading about that one, that is called as the most positive, one who is an inspiration behind the inspiration, all inspirers, is that God. I am talking, reading about Supreme God, the reading about the illumined souls. And when I start reading, my life also get inspired. I should also do something like this. And that is why our Indian tradition, the mothers, our parents used to tell children, small babies, that stories about great achievers, stories about the illumined souls, stories about the God. And hearing that one, behind that one, may this child hear about that one as it grows up and get inspired in the life. Our great grandmother used to tell the story. It is only the intention behind that one. You lead an inspired life. And I am talking, reading about the what is perfect. And religion, all religious texts, talks about defines the God according to the taste of the people, in different shades it defines what is God. And the Patanjali talks about God is klesha, karma, vipaka, ashayar, Purusha, Vishesha, Ishvara. It's a Klesha, Karma, Vipaka, Ashayar, Aparamrishta. Purusha, Vishesha, Vishesha, Ishvara. It is talking about God is that one. We can't perceive what God is. It is talking about Klesha. Klesha, Klesha. Whatever I have to do, I have to struggle. My life is a struggle. If I have to go to somewhere, there's a traffic jam. If I want to go to buy something, there's a product is out of stock, or I don't have money. Klesha. and klesha, karma, whatever I have to do, what I'll say, it is my karma, I have to do. I have no choice. In the why I'm working, even if I don't like it, my karma, I have to feed my family. And that is karma. And the third one, vipaka. Whatever I do, there is a repercussion. I like gulab jamun, and so tasty, I tasted two. No, it is not enough. I want three. I want five. I eat 10. After eating 10, my stomach is upset. I have stomach pain. Whatever the karma has a negative negative effect. Repercussion is there. Klesha, karma, vipaka, ashayar. I have so much of desire. I want to buy a house in near the CBD. I want to buy a house near the sea. I want to go to Kailash Manasayatra. I want to go. I want to go to holiday there. So much of desire in my life. And for Aparamrishta, for God, there is no difficulty, no shortfalls. And he has no obligatory duty, and whatever he does, there is no negative repercussion on that one. And klesha, karma, vipaka, ashayar, there is no, it's a desire complete, there is a, everything, it's a apta kama, he is complete, there is nothing more to be achieved by him. Ashayar, aparamrishta, is a paramrishta means unfulfilled. Aparamrishta means everything fulfilled. Purusha Vishesha Ishvara. It's a definition of Purusha Vishesha Ishvara. That is the definition of, one definition of God Patanjali has beautifully given. And he talks about, further talks about Tatra Sarvajnyatva Bijam. In him, everything is complete. Knowledge complete. Whatever topic, whatever subject, whatever dimension, you contemplate, it is there in him, Sarvajnyatva Bijam. Okay, when he was there, it is talking about Sa Purvesham Api Guru Kalena Va Achyadet. And in the Guru is the one, my Guruji, it's, his lifespan between 1945 to whatever, 2025. And his Guru may be with something. And time-bound gurus, but whereas he is Guru's Guru, he is an eternal Guru, he is the Jagat Guru. He is the Guru behind the Guru. He is the most ancient Guru, and he is the not a time-bound Guru. He is an eternal Guru. He is called as Jagat Guru. That Isha and that definition of God, it is the all texts, religious texts, are talking about that God. That when I start reading about that one, yes, I want to know about that one, more about that one. And to know more about that one, who has realized in the text, they talk about great illumined people. They have done that one sadhana. They have done this one. And you also can do. The purpose of all religious texts, why we have to do, it is not to only to show off that I am a very religious person. The purpose of swadhyaya, purpose of swadhyaya, you have to become something special in your life. You have to become something great in your life. You should become something, your life should be an inspiration for others. For that, the swadhyaya, that you had to do the swadhyaya without interruption every day. Read the text, religious text, which you are belonging to, which religion you are belonging to. But not get satisfied only outer meaning. Contemplate on that one. Look for the inner meaning. And Ishvara Pranidhana. When I am reading about that one, seeing the greatness of the God, my head bows down. I surrender to him. I surrender to his will. I totally surrender. When I totally surrender, I become a fit instrument for God to reflect that his reflection start reflecting on my me, that his being starts. When I surrender, I purify myself. When it starts reflecting, my life becomes an inspiration for others. By Ishwara Pranidhana, I enrich my Swadhyaya. My Swadhyaya, when it is enriched, with the enrichment, I can go deep into my tapas. When I start doing tapas, my santosha, happiness in my life goes up. When that happiness goes up, I go stay away from impure things. So, it is a personality development. If you want to develop, the personality development courses are being done by many management schools. The yoga talks about this is the personality development. You have to develop. When you are developed this way, you do nothing but you add value to the community. Your existence itself is a great asset to the community. Then Yama, whatever mentioned, Yama, you start adding value to the community. And Swadhyaya, you start reflecting, read the scriptures, look for the inner meaning. With devotion, with humility, with surrender, I want to know about the Supreme Lord. I am not reading the scriptures to show off my skills, my talent, my intellectual this one. I quote many things to impress others. It is not for impressing. It is for going deep, deep, so that my devotion to the Lord enhances. I should surrender to the Lord. I should get the grace of the Lord. Ishwara Pranidhana should happen. This niyama, it is applicable not only people who are doing yoga. All walks of life, if they start doing this one, their existence is of great value for others. This, lie down on your back.